A very warm good morning to everyone. Today, I, Bhavna Sharma, journalist at FairGaze, is present in a school where it is about goodness before greatness. This is the school, Bal Bhavan Public School. And today, I will not say that I'm privileged, but I will say that I'm honored to be with the person, the personality, who has taught not just me, but millions of students who are actually doing great in all the corners of the world. He's dynamic, he's charismatic, and he's none other than Mr. Vivid Gupta, the Vice Principal of Bal Bhavan Public School. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Bhavna. Thank you so much. Good morning, everybody.
Sir, I would like to know from you that how do you empower teachers to be leaders in your school?
See, empowering teachers to be the leaders is something which has been my target goal. And I have started investing in that also. And by the means, when I say that I'm investing in them, is something that I trust them. I give them the ownership that they are a part of the ecosystem, and yes, they have to be, they are certainly the change makers, but now they have to lead and inculcate that leadership in their children also.
True.
So when that responsibility follows, that I as a leader have to empower others, then things begin to, you know, flourish. True. Then there is no problem.
True. Well said, sir. Sir, another thing, you know, since our school days, we are taught that honesty is the best policy. But when we move to, or even all the children, when they move to corporate, even the Bollywood or the creative field, like advertising, the things are not the same. So is it like honesty is really the best policy?
Well, certainly honesty is best, but whether it is best policy or not, we can't comment on that. And as teacher, you know, we will always strive hard to tell our children that, you know, be honest, be loyal, and be faithful to whatever you do, with whomsoever you are. But yes, keeping in mind today's scenario in the world, and to keep yourself maintained at certain position, I certainly feel that a little manipulation is definitely required. But still, the point that honesty is the best policy, I will second that.
True. Well said, sir. And you know, sir, discipline is really essential for all the children. So how do you advocate discipline without punishment in the school?
Discipline never comes with punishment. I have been an advocate of, you know, saying that discipline never comes with force.
True.
We have to inculcate that discipline from within.
True.
And that is only possible when teachers and parents both collaborate together.
True.
And it's a teamwork. We have to make the children realize and make them understand why discipline is important for them. Number two, what we preach, we need to practice that in our life. So if, like your last question, when you say honesty is the best policy, if I teach that to my children, but I do not follow that, I do not practice that, it's gone. So similar is with discipline. So discipline is not just keeping quiet in the class. That does not define discipline. Unfortunately, in our schools, the definition of discipline has been limited to being quiet in the classroom.
True.
Whereas the actual lessons of school starts after the last bell of the school.
True.
So we need to understand that point and observe that in our scenario and situations where our children are growing, the fields, the playgrounds, there we have to see the discipline. If there is self-discipline over there, we have succeeded. If the discipline does not exist there, there is some problem and we need to find a solution.
True. Well said. That is such a nice answer from you. Now let's get to the rapid fire round with you. So we will start with the rapid fire round. So the first question is, which examination system must be followed in India? CBSE board or CBSE CCE?
CBSE board or CBSE CCE is what we have decided. I think the idea is to make the children educated and not literate.
True.
Right. So saying that CBSE board is better than CBSE CCE or CBSE CCE is better because there's lesser pressure, there's no comparison. Both are two different ends and they can never meet. But yes, certainly, I definitely feel that, you know, we need to have a little competition, and keeping that in mind, I think examination pattern is certainly required at school. Not because we need to evaluate the children, but we need to teach the children that in real life, if you have two things sailing together and you have to manage them, so examination teaches them, examination at school. Like, for example, you know, February is a month when the, February, March is the time when most of the practical examinations, the theory examinations will begin. And that is the season for wedding in Indian culture. So the children know, you know, I receive applications every now and then, ki exam nahi ho payega, ya next day exam hai, how things will happen. So I always tell them, see, if you have studied the whole year,
true,
toh exam should not be a phobia.
True.
And if it is about just appearing because you are not here, I will reconduct the exam. True. But if you were here and you do not want to appear for the examination because you were in a party last night, I think that should not be an excuse. You should know if you are partying hard, you should know when to study hard.
Study hard.
So both the balances are required.
True. Well said. The another one is, which language should be preferred, English or Hindi?
Globally English. But if I'll say, हमारे भारत के लिए हिंदी से बढ़िया कुछ नहीं है.
Great. Then the best stream for students, science, commerce or humanities?
Whatever the child likes. But whatever subject you study, the good thing is if you are a good human being, you are good at everything.
Great. Then children should focus on success or excellence?
I think excellence, certainly, because success will follow after.
Okay.
Yes.
Then the last one is, studies in India or studies abroad?
I would preferably say India, because you have to ultimately be here with your parents, with your family, with your... Yes, in case you decide ki you have to move on and you don't want to be here, then you have your own choices. So really no comments on that. It depends on personal choices.
That was so amazing interacting with you, with the amazing answers we received. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bhavna. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much to all the lovely children for watching us. And if you want to know more about Bal Bhavan Public School and the Vice Principal of the school, Mr. Vivid Gupta, then please log on to www.faegaze.com and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.